Now that we know what a metal semiconductor junction is, let's derive the current voltage characteristic of these junctions and examine some specific examples. In the previous video, I showed two different metal semiconductor junctions. The Schottky barrier junction, in which the difference in work functions is such that the barriers formed for electrons to travel from the n-type semiconductor into the metal, and the ohmic junction, in which such a barrier is absent. So far, we did not consider the flow of charge carriers across the junction. In this video, we will focus on this current flow across the junction. However, in order to understand the underlying physics, we first discuss the process of thermionic emission. We will then discuss how the current flow can be influenced by invoking the tunneling process and how this affects the contact resistance. Let us first have a look again at the band diagram of an n-type semiconductor. We've characterized this semiconductor by the electron affinity, defined as the energy difference between the vacuum level and the bottom of the conduction band, and the work function, defined as the energy difference between the vacuum level and the Fermi level. The energy difference between the bottom of the conduction band and the Fermi level is indicated by phi n and is controlled by the dopant concentration. Now suppose that the semiconductor is in contact on the left-hand side with vacuum. You've seen before that at a given temperature, the electron distribution as a function of energy in the conduction band has a drop-like shape, as shown here. If the temperature is increased to sufficiently high values, this distribution becomes wider, and we find that some electrons have a finite possibility to have an energy higher than the vacuum level. These electrons have so much energy that they can be emitted from the material. This process is called thermionic emission. We can find an expression for the density of these thermally emitted electrons by integrating the energy-dependent electron density from the minimal energy required for emission, the electron affinity, to infinity. In turn, the energy-dependent electron density is equal to the product of the occupation function and the energy-dependent density of states of the conduction band, indicated here by Gc. For the occupation function, we should use the Fermi-Dirac function, indicated here by FFD. But as the energy difference between the Fermi level and the vacuum level is large, we can use the Maxwell-Boltzmann approximation for the Fermi-Dirac function. That enables us to work out easily the density of thermally emitted electrons, and we find that this is dependent exponentially on the sum of the electron affinity and the energy difference between the conduction band and the Fermi level. This is, in fact, the work function of this material. Now we have some understanding of thermionic emission, we turn our attention to the Schottky barrier junction, and we will focus on the barrier only. The current density across this junction at zero bias will consist of two components: electrons that travel from the semiconductor to the metal, indicated by Js2m, and vice versa, electrons that travel from the metal to the semiconductor, indicated here by Jm2s. As at zero bias no current flowing, these two components evidently should be equal. If we now take a look at the energy-dependent electron distribution just in front of the barrier, we can see that some electrons have sufficient thermal energy to cross this barrier. Those are shown here in the shaded part of the drop. In a similar way, as I have shown a couple of minutes ago, we can work out the density of these electrons, and we find that this density depends exponentially on the Schottky barrier height. Using these findings, we can work out the current density at zero volt bias by stating that the current flow from the semiconductor to the metal should be equal to the flow from the metal to the semiconductor, and that this in turn is proportional to the density of thermally emitted electrons via proportionality constant A. Now that we understand how current flows through a Schottky barrier at 0 biases, we can move to the Schottky barrier junction in forward bias. When applying a forward bias, the barrier for electrons in the semiconductor traveling to the metal is reduced by the applied voltage. This has consequences for the current flow. The injection of electrons from the metal does not change as the Schottky barrier that controls this flow remains the same. The current flow from the semiconductor to the metal, however, changes strongly as the barrier for electrons in the semiconductor to travel to the metal is now reduced. Working out the thermally emitted electron density, we see that this is now dependent on the applied voltage. We can now derive the current voltage relationship by working out the net current across the junction. Using the same proportionality constant A and inserting the appropriate barrier height to represent the thermally emitted electrons across the barrier for the two current components, we find an exponential voltage dependence of the current across this junction, expressing the rectifying behavior of a large current flow at forward bias and virtually no current at reverse bias. The metal semiconductor junctions showing this rectifying behavior are called Schottky diodes. Now let's have a closer look at this relationship. The prefactor JS of this relationship contains the Schottky barrier as derived earlier. In addition, a more exact derivation will show a dependence on the temperature squared as well as a specific constant. This constant, A star, is called the effective Richardson constant and depends, amongst other parameters, on the effective mass of the charge carriers. When we compare the relationship we found for the Schottky barrier to the current voltage characteristics of a PN diode, we see that the voltage dependence for the two junctions is the same. The main difference is the prefactor, often called the saturation or leakage current density. Whereas for the Schottky diode, this saturation current density depends on the Schottky barrier seen by majority carriers in the semiconductor, the saturation current density for the PN junction depends on the diffusion properties and concentrations of minority carriers. As a result, the Schottky barrier saturation current density is orders of magnitude larger than that of the PN junction. So far, we have looked at a situation in which the depletion region is fairly wide and only thermionic emission is important. When we increase the doping concentration in the semiconductor, the situation changes. In that case, the conduction band and the valence band move downwards, but as the Schottky barrier height phi Bn remains the same, the built-in voltage will become larger. In addition, as a result of the higher doping concentration, the depletion region width becomes smaller. If the width becomes small enough, like I've drawn here, then we may have the situation that electrons in the conduction band may penetrate through the Schottky barrier rather than being emitted over it. This process is called tunneling. In order to have an idea on how this works, we simplify the Schottky barrier by a square potential step. Electrons having a given energy, E, moving towards this potential step have a finite possibility to tunnel through this barrier. To work out the transmission through this energy barrier is a common quantum mechanics problem, and we find this equation for the transmission squared that reflects the amplitude of the transmitter signal and is proportional to the current density. It is important to see that this transmittance depends exponentially on the depletion region width and the Schottky barrier height through the parameter kappa. Applying this procedure to the Schottky barrier, an expression can be found for the tunneling current density, Jt. To arrive at this equation, the expression for the depletion region width has been inserted and the argument of the exponential function has been rearranged. important to see is that the tunneling current density depends exponentially on the Schottky barrier height, phi bn, and on the dopant concentration. For solar cell applications, we are often interested in the specific contact resistance between the semiconductor and the metal. This is defined as the inverse of the derivative of the current voltage relationship and evaluated at zero bias. We can work out easily for the Schottky barrier when the current voltage relationship is governed by thermionic emission and for the case that tunneling is dominating the current flow mechanism. In the latter, we can now see clearly that the doping concentration in the semiconductor can mitigate the effect of the Schottky barrier height, phi bn, when increased to large values. When plotting the specific contact resistance, we can see the drop in resistance clearly with increasing dopant concentration in the semiconductor. We will see in later videos how this is implemented in solar cells. In conclusion, we have seen that the Schottky barrier junction has a rectifying current voltage relationship, meaning that the current density is exponentially dependent on the voltage. This relationship is controlled by thermionic emission of majority carriers across the Schottky barrier. For high doping concentrations, the effect of the Schottky barrier can be mitigated by tunneling of charge carriers through this barrier.